Whoa. Hi, everybody. Hang on while I get my camera situated here. It's always a kind of a pain. Okay. Hi, everybody. Thanks so much for tuning in. I'm trying to get my... Yes, I'm here to taste Oreos. And let's see. I have three things. See, now I'm trying to get this... Okay. Whatever. I'm gonna try to slow down the comments, but yeah. Anyways, hi everyone. Thanks so much for joining me today. I have Oreos for you. Just a few flavors that I've collected. And apple pie is the new fall season flavor, I believe. Limited edition. And I found this one about a month ago, and this is the Dunkin' Donuts mocha version. And this one looks very promising. I don't know if this is regional, though. Is this... I live in New England, which is in on the East Coast. I don't know. Have you guys seen these ones around? And the last one I had are these ones. And these are the Oreo Thins. And they are the salted caramel flavor. So, I have high hopes for most of these. These all sound pretty reasonable. The apple pie one I am excited about because I'm planning on using this in a recipe. I found this crazy Oreo, giant Oreo mold. Like, you can make two cakes, right? I found this at the thrift store for like $3. So I bought them and I thought, I know I'm a bit late on the whole giant Oreo trend, but I thought I could make a golden version of this and then put an apple pie in there. I'm gonna do like a take on a Cherrypumpel and put an actual apple pie in the cake and then make some sort of frosting and then crush up some of these in there. I thought, I don't know. So that's the plan for now. But I thought it'd be best to taste the Oreos first before I actually did that whole thing. Oh, so many people from so many different places. We have London, we have Jakarta, Indonesia, what else? Hi, everybody. Thanks so much for tuning in. Okay, and Sweden and LA. All right, so I think the first one I'm going to taste are the Dunkin' Donuts ones. Dunkin' Donuts mocha flavor. Dunkin' Donuts is huge here on the East Coast, really huge. You always see people drinking these, even in the middle of winter, people are drinking their iced coffees. So let's give this one a taste. There they are. They smell delicious. Oreo and coffee, but very sweet. A little bit vanilla. Alright, so Oreo cookie with the famous Oreo words on here. Minnesota and Serbia, West Ireland, Honduras. Okay, so let's give this a little twist. And it opens cleanly. And the frosting is a light kind of brown color. Right, let's give that a go. Cheers. Oh, itadakimasu. Yeah. I approve of this message. Mm-hmm. It has a very good coffee flavor. Distinctive coffee flavor, mocha flavor, because it's very sweet and kind of a little bit chocolatey because, of course, the crust or the cookies are chocolatey, but I believe the frosting's gonna be a little bit chocolatey too. Let's try the frosting. Yeah, that's great. That is a classic combination, chocolate, coffee put together in a cookie. This is a delicious cookie. Mm-hmm. And tastes a lot like a mocha. I shouldn't say. It doesn't taste like a Brandon Dunkin' Donuts mocha because a mocha tastes like a mocha, but this is delicious. A great combination of chocolate and coffee. And I think it very accurately gets the whole Dunkin' Donuts-ness because it is so stinking sweet, but scrumptious. Mm-hmm. It does look a little double stuffed. Someone just mentioned that this looks a little double stuffed and it does, but I don't think they are. Good. I think they would be even better dipped in milk. I forgot to take a lactase enzyme, so I'm not going to be consuming any milk. But I think Dunked, even more mocha-like, right? So, look, I got new shirts. More information about that on emmymadeinjapan.com. I'm going to have shirts for soon. Super excited about that. Baseball tees, perfect for fall. This is my old school design, look. Next, let's try this one. And these kind of remind me of like a diet version of Oreos because they're super thin. It doesn't really market itself as so. It just calls themselves thins. And I've tried the coconut version, the regular version, and the mint version. And they're all pretty good. I like the texture of these ones quite a lot. So, but have I ever had the golden? I don't think I've had the golden. I certainly haven't had the salted caramel. So, let's see. And this one is new. It doesn't say limited edition, so maybe this is a permanent flavor. I don't know. I have not had the tiramisu ones. And I've had the lemon, but not lemon thin. Okay, wow, look at that. So orderly, nice. These smell like graham crackers. They don't smell like Oreos to me, but they still have the same Oreo pattern, and they're significantly thin. Like if we do a side-by-side there, like look. Half as much of everything, right? So you can eat twice as much. Let's see if I can open it. Yeah, opens nicely. Has a nice caramel-colored filling in there. Put this back together. All right, let's give that a go. This is the salted caramel Oreo thin. Okay. You know, I would say this, but taste is subjective, and the golden Oreos just really aren't my favorite. They taste grammy. I much prefer the chocolate because I'm a chocolate nut, so it makes absolute sense, right? So the outside of this cookie tastes just like the golden Oreos, a little bit grammy, sweet, vanilla, and the inside has the salted caramel, of course. I like the amount of salt. The salt is really nice, and it has a slight kind of caramelly flavor, but the predominant flavor for me is golden, kind of graham. Kind of meh for me, but again, it's because I think it's because I just don't like the golden cookie as much. I do like the texture of the thins. It has a very pleasant kind of crispness to it, and it's very well balanced with the amount of filling in there. Sometimes these can be a little bit hard, you know, because it's just a lot of cookie and a lot of, you know, relative to this. So I think this combination of cookie and filling really works for me. Of course, it doesn't feel like a traditional Oreo because we've all are used to this, but this is actually quite nice. But salted caramel? No, I'd still go for original or mint. Okie dokie, okie dokies. Alright, now for the fall edition, we have apple pie. And it says it's a graham-flavored cookie, and the apple is probably going to be in the middle, I guess, yeah? And yeah. Artificially flavored, if you weren't sure. Oh, look at this. I've never noticed that before. Slit appears when opened. Okay, if you say so. Ooh. Yes. It smells like Apple Jacks. You know the cereal? That apple-y smell one, that, you know, that smell you get. Not being very articulate at the moment. And if we compare it to the thins, it's a little darker in color, but this is supposed to be a graham cookie. So it's not the golden cookie, it's a graham cookie. And there's the filling. Oop, didn't open cleanly, but it has kind of a caramel color to them. Kind of smells as you expect, kind of like those apple cider donuts, kind of that smell. Very strong. All right, here we go. Let's give that a taste. Hmm. Well, that one. I don't really like that one very much. I know it says right on the package that it says artificially flavored, like unabashedly, this is not real. But this tastes really fake. Like, really fake. Like Apple Jacks on steroids. The cookie itself, let's try that. Actually, the cookie is not very sweet and lightly grammy. I was expecting it to be really grammy. Same texture as an Oreo though, that kind of hard cookie crunch. I think all that apple flavor is in the filling. Ugh, no, don't like that at all. It tastes like I'm walking into like Michael's or AC Moore or something. It has that fall autumnal scented stuff they spray all over the place. Not pumpkin pie, but apple spice. That's what this tastes like. Yeah, not very good. Kind of floral too. So yeah, but if you like apple pie or apple artificial flavored stuff, maybe this is for you. At any rate, I'm going to try using these since I have them in my giant apple pie Oreo thing and see how it turns out. We'll see. Look, I don't know. Have you guys ever used one of these silicone baking pans? I'm a little bit skeptical, but you know, why not? I got this at a thrift store. I'm sure you can order these online, but I just saw these at a thrift store used for $3.99, so I got them. And I said, why not? A little bit late on the giant Oreo train, but better late than never. And who's ever made an apple pie one? I'm gonna put an apple pie, like a full-on apple pie inside the cake. But I think I might have to use like mini apple pies, or I don't know. I've gotta kind of figure that stuff out. Anyway, look for that video soon. Look for a t-shirt soon at mmadeinjapan.com. And yeah. All right, guys, I'm gonna go pick up my son from kindergarten, and my other son's about to wake up from a nap. So thank you guys so much for tuning in, and yes, I would recommend this flavor, especially if you like, you know, mocha. All right, I shall see you next week. I usually will do I'll be doing these lives either on Thursdays or Fridays from 1 to 3 Eastern time. So yeah, I'll see y'all next week. Toodaloo, take care, bye.